everyone. Welcome to Topic of the Day. In this edition, we shall be discussing about India's ethanol blending policy. Now, recently, this was in news as the Union Cabinet approved amendments to the National Policy on Biofuels 2018. Now, let us discuss what are the amendments made to this policy. Firstly, its advancement of date, by which fuel companies have to increase the percentage of ethanol in petrol to 20%. And it is advanced from 2030 to 2025. Earlier, the target was to achieve 10% blending in petrol by the year 2022 and 10% in diesel by 2030. If we talk about the history of ethanol blending in India, in the year 2001, India has tested the feasibility of ethanol blended petrol, whereby 5% ethanol blended petrol, that is 95% petrol and 5% ethanol, was supplied to retail outlets. In the year 2002, India launched the ethanol blended petrol program and began selling 5% ethanol blended petrol in 9 states, which was extended to 20 states and 4 union territories in 2006. In the year 2015, Ministry of Road Transport and Highways notified E5, that means blending 5% ethanol with 95% gasoline. Again, in 2019, the ministry notified E10 fuel, which meant blending 10% ethanol with 90% gasoline. Now, the standards for E20, E85, and even E100 fuel have already been laid. Again, in 2020, India has been announcing its intent to achieving 10% blending by the end of 2022 and 20% blending by 2030. Now, let us discuss on the advantages of this move. Firstly, it will help save the precious forex reserves. That is, Niti Aayog in its 2021 report said that it saved rupees 30,000 crore of foreign exchange per year. Increased energy security, as India imports more than 70% of its domestic crude requirement from abroad. Thirdly, it is eco-friendly. That is, it lowers carbon emissions, resulting in better air quality. There is also judicious use of otherwise wasted crops, which will also help in increasing the farmers' income. Also, we have increased self-reliance as it allows more feedstock for producing biofuel and foster the development of indigenous technologies. We have Flex Fuel Engine Technology, FFE, or vehicles that run entirely on ethanol, which are popular in Brazil. Now, if we talk about the disadvantages of the move, firstly, it would increase the vehicle's price level and the land is also diverted for non-food purposes. Also, there is technology suboptimal to other green technologies. And when using the E20, there is an estimated loss of 6 to 7% fuel efficiency. Now, even though there is a loss of carbon monoxide, but still there is no reduction in the nitrous oxides. Now, let us talk about the possible way ahead. Firstly, with modifications in engines, the loss in efficiency due to blended fuel can be reduced. Secondly, tax incentives on E20 fuel may be considered. Also, we can consider the Niti Aayog's report that talks about comprehensive picture of ethanol blending, challenges and a roadmap. The National Biofuel Policy 2018 categorizes biofuels as basic biofuels, 1G first generation, 2G second generation and 3G biofuels, that is the third generation biofuels. Now, let us take up a practice question on this topic. With reference to ethanol, consider the following statements. Firstly, ethanol is an organic chemical compound. Second, it can only be naturally produced by fermentation of sugars by yeasts. Third, it is considered as renewable fuel. And fourth, India aims for 20% ethanol blended fuel by 2030. Now, which of these statements given above are correct? You can write your answers in the comment section below. So the correct answer is B, that is only the first and third statements. Well, that's a wrap of today's edition of Topic of the Day. For regular updates, you can follow us on our social media handles. And for more such videos, do stay tuned to the next IAS YouTube channel.